Hello everybody, this is Minuchandra Mandal, Scholastic English. Today I am before you to deal an important topic on creative writing, that is letter writing. Let us know more about letter writings. We know that the basic purpose of a letter is communication. It takes a message across and expresses certain ideas. We find two kinds of letters. They are formal letters and informal letters. All kinds of official or letters related to business are formal letters. All kinds of social letters, private letters, that comes under informal letters. You see, there are business letters related to orders, sales letters of recommendations, resignation letter, job letters related to complaints, letters related to educational institutions, all kinds of official invitations, request letters to official organizations, letters to editors of newspaper, all these are formal letters. Letters to our friends, parents, sometimes we write the letters of advice to our juniors or superiors, letters of condolences, all letters of expressing thanks, all kinds of private invitations, letters related to regret, letters of acceptance, all kinds of apologies, letters of family, letters of sympathy, all these are called as social letters or private letters, and these social letters and private letters are informal letters. Some social letters are semi-formal. Because when you are writing letters to our elders or superiors, in case of private letters, we write the letter in a semi-formal way. Let us know more about the formal letter. We follow these steps. First of all, we write the sender's address and date, then receiver's address, then the subject, then salutation, then you write body of the letter, thereafter comes the complimentary or closing, then after closing we write sender's name, signature and designations, then postscript. Let us know details regarding all these steps. First of all, we will discuss sender's address and date of the formal letters. First, the sender's address can be written in two ways. They are indented form with punctuation or block form with punctuations. In case of indented forms, what are the things we include? First, name or designations. Then we write the address, the place from where the sender is writing the letter, than the date. You see, there are two forms as I told you. When you are writing the indented form with punctuation, we have to give some space after each step. Your name, after name, when you are writing the place, you have to give some space. After that, you have to give some space. When you are writing at the end, the date, we have to give some space. And we use punctuation mark. And here, in the block form, we do not give any space, but we have to mention, write any one of the form. There are certain ways of writing date. You can write the name of the day first, then the date in order, then month, then year. Order, you know that there are two forms of writing the numbers. They are cardinal number and the ordinal number. The number which indicates the order, that first, second, third, fourth, fifth, 21st, 22nd, is the ordinal number. So you can use the ordinal number here. And similarly, the second way of writing the date is, you can mention the ordinal number of the date first, then the month, then the year. When you are writing month, you have to write the capital letter. Similarly, you can write the month first, then the date, then the year. So when you are writing the date in ordinal number, that is 10, 11, 20, 21, you have to separate the year and the date with the comma. Similarly, 10-9-2020, this is another way of writing, and 10-9-2020, this is another way of writing. So we can follow any one of the way of writing date. Let us know about the two address or the inside address. The two address or the inside address can be written in two ways. They are indented form and or the blocked form. You can use any one of the form. What do you mean by indented form? Indented form is nothing but giving some space after each item. You look at this, you will have good understanding about the indented form of writing letter address. In the indented form, you see, when you are writing two address, we should mention two. We should not use punctuation mark after two. Then you have to mention the official whom you are writing. Suppose here, this sub-inspector of police, town police station, Ichapura municipality, Srikakulam district, Andhra Pradesh. You see, for every item or every step, you are giving some space or indentation. Therefore, this is indented form. And for every step, you have to use punctuation mark. And similarly, blocked form is nothing but we do not give any space. We do not give any space or indentation after each step. So this is the blocked form. So we can adopt any one of the form while writing the inside address. Let us know what should you write in the salutation part. You see, there are two kinds of writing salutations. Salutations written to the people who are quietly unknown, who are quietly stranger to us, and salutation to the people who are well known to us. So when you are writing the letter to a person who are quite unknown, or those who are higher superior to us, then we write dear sir or dear madam. Similarly, simply sir or madam. Or similarly, we can write respected sir, respected madam. When we do not know the gender, we can write sir or madam. If you particularly know the gender, you can write, if it's a male, then you just write sir. If it's a female or lady, we can write madam. When you do not know the gender, you simply write sir here. So another way of writing salutations to the people who are well known is, you can write, start with dear Mr. Mahapatro, dear Mistress Rajarao, dear Miss Patel, dear Dr. Patel. You can write in this way the name, you can write the short name of the person that you are well known. But think that he must be, he may be your junior. Okay, if he somebody is senior, we also can write, but we can mention the dear sir or madam or respected sir. In this way, salutations can be written in two ways. Let us know about the subject of the formal letters. You see, subject of the formal letter should be very brief. It may contain one or two lines. If it is maximum, it may contain three lines. The subject of the formal letter must convey the matter for which the letter is written. After that, we write the body or the content of the formal letter. This is the main part of the letter, that letter which conveys the message, which conveys the purpose of the letter, which conveys the detailed information of the letter. You see, the body of the letter can be classified into three parts. They are introduction, then the message or details of the matter, then the conclusion mentioning expectations. Let us know the introduction. Introduction is short introduction on purpose of the letter. The purpose of the letter may be inquiry, the purpose of letter may be a complaint, the purpose of letter may be seeking for information or giving information. The sort of introduction may be on counseling, or it may be requests. So whatever it may be, the content part should begins with the introduction. Then let us know detail about the matter or the content of the message. With the content part may have one paragraph or two paragraph or three or four paragraph, but it should not be too much lengthy. So when you are writing the matter or the message, you should keep in mind that keep the information to the essential and the concentrate on the organizing it in a clear and a logical manner. And it should be good and simple language. It should not be clumsy, bombastic, more and much bombastic words, more and more bombastic words should not be used, because sometimes it creates disturbance. Because similarly, when you are writing the paragraphs, when you know very well that the paragraph must contain a unity, order and variety. So every paragraph that should be unity, order and variety. Unity is nothing but the unity of ideas and sub ideas. So relation between ideas and sub ideas. Then we have to mention the order, what comes after what. Then the variety, variety in our language, variety of our vocabularies, variety of the sentences. So all kinds of variety has to be maintained. Remember that each paragraph should begin with the sentence which is called key sentence, and that key sentence should convey the message of the entire paragraph. Let us know in the introduction part, there are some ways of expressions that we can adopt while writing the official or the formal letters. If the I have already discussed that the purpose may be inquiry, the purpose may be complaint, the purpose may be giving information, the purpose may be request. So the purpose, the introduction varies according to the purpose of the letter. Similarly, you can begin the letter with "I venture to draw your kind notice." Then what are the matters? What are the subject matters you can write? You have to write that. Or you can begin the letter "I wish to draw your kind attention." Similarly, you can write, "I am constrained to bring to your notice that." Notice that what? Whether it is a complaint, you would write something complaint. Okay, complaint. Similarly, if it is a request, then write some words or some the sentences regarding request. Similarly, it's a most, another way of writing is, it is too much polite. It's a most humbly and respectfully, "I would like to put forth the grievances that." Similarly, you can begin the introduction with, "With due respect, I would like to submit that." In this way, we can begin the introductions. Similarly, conclusion we have not discussed so far. We will discuss it. And in the conclusion, you see, the conclusion is nothing but the final paragraph of the body of the letter. And the conclusion suggests the actions to be taken, or closing remarks, or expresses understanding, promises, and making final request. You see, the conclusion can be begin with like this, that "we hope you will like to go into the matter immediately and take some measures to." Similarly, you can say, "I earnestly request you to take necessary action." In this way, we can conclude the body of the letter. Now, after the body of the letter, we have to write a sentence and the complimentary closing. So what is the complimentary closing? When you are writing the official letter, with a "thanking you sir," or "thanking you madam," or "thanking you in anticipation," or "thanking you in advance." So we can write any of such expressions, or we can add your more and more, you can make beautify and write your own. Then these are the complimentary closing. So after the complimentary closing, we write the subscription. The subscriptions also varies from person to person. You see, if those persons, those who are unknown to us, those who are quite superior to us, when you write in the salutation part, "dear sir," "dear madam," "sir," "madam," "respected," when you are writing all this, so for them, you have to write the subscription as yours faithfully. Similarly, when you are writing the person chose who are well known to us, as a "dear Smith," "dear Mohapatra," you have already written, you can write yours sincerely. So you can write any one of these, yours faithfully or yours sincerely. If the salutation is dear sir, dear madam, sir, madam, respected sir, you are spitefully. If the salutation like dear, then name is the persons who are well known to us, those who are junior to us, you can write yours sincerely. And after writing that, we have to write the sender's name, signature and designations. So after the subscription part, we write the signature. When you are writing the signature of any form letter, we should write the full name and the designations. Is there any particulars we can mention here? Let us go through the format of the formal letter. You see, this is the format. As I have told you, sender's name and address can be written at the top of the left side of the paper. So after that, two receivers at the below to the right hand side, we can write the two are the receiver's address. Then below that, we can write salutations, after that subject, after that body of the letter, after that complimentary closing, then the subscription and the signature. Now look here, you see there are two ways of writing. You see, somebody they write subject first, then the salutation, and there's somebody they write the salutation first, then the subject. So these two kinds of writings are allowed. So in this way, this is the format of formal letters. Let us go through one or two examples, formal letters. You see, here is a formal letter. A student writes to the headmaster seeking for the board certificates. So here the official letters, he begins with the from is here Arupananda Birlengi, Ichhapura Mandalam. Here he wrote the date. You see, in the from part, he wrote at the left side. So whenever he wrote the from, he used the punctuation mark. And for the to address or the inside address, he begins with the to. He did not use any punctuation mark. We should not use any punctuation mark after to. Then the headmaster, Jilla Parishad High School, Birlengi, Ichhapuram. So after each step, he used punctuation mark. And after that, he wrote the salutation as respected sir. Or he might have wrote dear sir. After that, he wrote subject. That is the soliciting for issuing my SSC board certificate along with TC and conduct certificate. Or if you are not using soliciting here, that is, you can write requesting or write for SSC board certificate along with TC and conduct certificate request regarding. After that, because he is a student and he wrote the letter to the headmaster, he begins with due respect and humble submission. I, Arupananda Baditya, a student of your esteemed school, submit that I studied from 6th to 10th class from the academic years 2015 to 2016 to 2019 to 2020 in your school. This year I appeared SS examinations and passed with A+ grade. As I aspire to join in a reputed college for my higher study, I need my SSC board certificate, transfer certificate and conduct certificate. Hence, I request you to issue my all the above mentioned testimonials, for which I shall remain grateful to you. Thanking you, sir, madam. Here he mentioned yours obediently, Arupananda Baditya, then his number. Now look at this, he followed almost all the steps of the formal letters. And the another way of formal type letters is, we can write the from here to the at the right hand side also, at the top of the right hand side. Then below that, we can write the to address. And he also mentioned, you see, this is salutation, this is subject. Then he also gave his introduction that I, Arupananda Baditya, student of esteemed college, and he's a student, he's introducing. And for what is the letter writing, he's writing, this is the message part. And he concluded the letter like the hands, I request you to closing. Therefore, this is the letter. He used yours obediently. And here is another kind of letter, that a letter to the police commissioner. So here you look at this. This letter also contains this is the from address. He wrote the address, then the date. While writing the date, he followed the order, the date of the order, then the month, then the year. Then he started with the to address here to the commissioner of police, police headquarter, New Delhi. You see, this is the two address. After that, he mentioned the subject, crime against the alleged request regarding. This is another verb, respected or sir, madam. So you see, this is the introduction part, and this is the in the body part. He just introduced, I wish to lodge a serious complaint with against. This is the introduction related to the question that is given here. Okay. Similarly, this is the actual matter, the message, the informations that he is conveying, and this is he is making the conclusion like that. I hope the police department will take some official measure to prevent crimes against the age. He wrote, yours truly. But actually, yours truly is written to our friends. So you can write yours faithfully or whatever. Here he wrote, suppose he's Arun. But it should not be Arun. It should be full name. It should be full name. So in this way, this is another kind of official letter. I hope we are very much clear about the official letter. Let us go through the informal letters. What are the informal letters? We have already discussed about the heading, salutations, body of the letter. I think we did not go through all the details again. Let us see what are the steps that we follow when you are writing an informal letter. The informal letter begins with the heading, then we write the salutations or greeting, then the body of the letter, then subscription or the leave-taking, then the signature of the sender, then true address on the envelope. So these are the steps we follow when you are writing informal letters. You see, in the salutation part, if the informal letter is written to the to our elders, to our superiors, to the persons in the higher stage, we write dear, thereafter we write the relation. Suppose if father, so father is elder to us. We should not mention father's name here. So dear father, sorry, F should be capital here. Dear mother, dear sister, dear sir, dear madam. Because if you are writing the private letters to anybody here, we can write dear sir also. And there is another way of writing the salutation is my dear father, my dear mother. But remember one thing, when you are writing my dear father, my dear mother, so my M will be capital, D will be small, then the relation will be capital. So from this we are clear that when you are writing a letter to our elders, we should write the relation, not the names. But when you are writing a letter to our youngers, we have to write younger sister, younger brother, our friends also, we have to write the name. Suppose you have the dear madan, dear Sneha. So this indicates that he is junior to us, either he is younger to us, or he may be our same status, same position. Then we can, or he may be our very close our friend. Then we have to write the name of the friend. Similarly, my dear Madan, my dear Sneha, we can write. And let us know as we have already discussed the body of the letter. The body of the letter seems to be same, but the introduction will be differ. So when you are writing the social letter, especially the subscription here, then the subscription varies from relation to relations. When you are writing to the near relatives, then the subscription will be yours faithfully. Yours faithfully. Similarly, your affectionate son, your affectionate sister, or you can write your loving daughter. Or similarly, we can bring the affectionately yours, faithful, affectionately yours, okay, or yours lovingly. So these are the subscriptions you have to write if you are writing these to our near relatives. But when you are writing the letter to our friends, the subscription will be like this. What is that? Yours sincerely, yours ever, or yours truly, we can write. Or truly yours, sorry, Y will be capital here. Y should be capital, sorry. Yours sincerely, yours. And after the subscription, we have to use punctuation. But when you are writing some acquaintances, you can write your sincerely. So in this way, we have to write the subscription. Let us go through some model private letters. You see, here are the private letters. Now, this letter you might have known that Jawaharlal Nehru wrote this letter टू श्रीमती इंदिरा गांधी व्हेन ही वाज इन जेल. तो हाउ द लेटर यू सी माय डियर इंदिरा. सो ही बिगिंस विथ माय डियर इंदिरा. यू सी एम कैपिटल, डी इज स्मॉल, इंदिरा आई इज द कैपिटल बिकॉज इंदिरा इज जूनियर टू नेहरू एंड इंदिरा इज द डॉटर ऑफ नेहरू. सो ही सेड माय डियर इंदिरा. सो ही मेंशनड द नेम. इट इज नो इजी मैटर टू डिसाइड व्हाट इज राइट एंड व्हाट इज नॉट. One little test I shall ask you to apply whenever you are in doubt. Never do anything in secret or anything that you would wish to hide. For the desire to hide anything means that you are afraid, and fear is a bad thing and unworthy of you. Be brave, and all the rest follows. You know that in our great freedom movement under Bapuji's leadership, there is no room for secrecy or hiding. We have nothing to hide. We are not afraid of what we do or what we say. We work in the sun and in the light. Even so, in the our private lives, let us make friends with the sun and work in the light and do anything secretly. And if you do so, my dear, you will grow up a child of the light and afraid and serene and unruffled. Whatever may happen, with all my love and good wishes, yours loving father. You see, yours loving father, Jawaharlal Nehru. This is one way of writing private letters. You see, this letter from Mahatma Gandhi. Mahatma Gandhi, M.K. Gandhi, wrote this letter when he was in Johannesburg. You see, this letter was written on 4th April 1910. You see, similarly, dear sir, this is a private letter. So he wrote dear sir also, because that person is not relative and neither is his relative, but he is well known to him. That's it, dear sir. This letter has been written to the Tolstoy. This letter is the correspondence between Tolstoy and Gandhiji. So you may remember that I have written to you from London, where I stopped temporarily. As you are devoted a follower, I send you here with a brief booklet which I have written. I have translated my own writings from Gujarati, my own language. What is remarkable is that my original book was confiscated by the government of India. Therefore, I was in a hurry to publish these translations. I am afraid I am burdening you. But if your health permits and you have time to go through my booklet, then I need not express how greatly I shall value your criticism of it. I am sending also a few copies of your a letter to Hindu which you allowed me to publish. This letter will also translated in an Indian dialect. Yours respectfully. You see, here he ended this letter with yours respectfully. This is also another way of writing. This letter has been written from by Mahatma Gandhi to Tolstoy. Now here is a private letter. A teacher wrote to another teacher on how to take care in this corona situations. You see, he wrote that he wrote it from Badavado, 11th June 2020. This is the heading he wrote. Then in the salutation he wrote, "My dear Krishna Chandra, your D is small." Now you see, this is the introduction he wrote. "I am well here and hope the same with you. Convey my regards to your parents and blessings to your younger one." You know, this is the body, you see the message part. You know, this is the situation that never happened before the times immemorial. So you need to be extra careful in your daily routine activities. Ever going out unless you feel any urgency under unavoidable circumstances. Take hot meals and drink hot water. Maintain social distance, wearing mask while outside, going outside. Sanitize before touching nose or mouth. Wash your dress materials at regular intervals. Take nutritious food to enhance immunity. Rest of the things are as usual. I hope, this is the conclusion. I hope you will practice all above things mindfully and advise others for their betterments. You see, in this way, introduction, then the message part,
then he made the conclusion like this. So conclusion may be one another paragraph. Next, you see, thanks with the expectations of getting reply quickly. You are sincerely, so you should be here, capital letter, you are sincerely Raghunath. Because when you are writing a letter, private letter, to our friends, we did not write the full name. We need not write also the full name. So this is Raghunath. This is a private letters. In this way, we know many more private letters. So I hope I covered almost all the areas of letter writing, formal and informal letters. I extend my heartfelt thanks to you for listening to me. I hope you will like this video and share it to your friends if you feel it is very important. Subscribe my channel. Thank you very much.